Hi, I'm Glyn Dewis. Welcome to episode 65. And this week, I've got a really cool technique for you, showing you how you can take a regular picture and turn it into a winter snow scene. All right, so this technique couldn't be any simpler. It's also incredibly quick to do, but putting those 2 points aside, it really is effective and realistic when you use it on the right picture. And there's a couple of points I'll mention right at the very end of the video to help you make sure that you do choose the right picture, and also a couple of things that will help you get exactly the look you're after. But that aside, let's just dive in now and show you how we can turn the picture you can see on screen now into a snow scene very, very quickly. What we're gonna do, we've got the picture open in Photoshop. I'm then going to go to the select menu and choose color range. Now when this comes up, we get this little preview box here, this properties within the color range, lots of options we can use to choose from, but I'm going to leave it set to sampled colors. And in this area here, we've got the world's smallest preview box here. This basically shows us what we're selecting within our picture. And the way we select something is just bring our cursor out, and when we bring it over the image, it changes into a color sampler. And all I'm going to do now is just start clicking around the picture in different areas until I get the kind of selection that I want. And this is the thing that you need to just practice. Don't expect to just open any old picture, click once, and get exactly the look you're after. What I found with this picture was, what I want to do is just click around to a certain point where I find that the majority of the selection is on the ground, exactly like you can see now. So it's very rarely is it you can see small amounts on the trees. They're pretty dark there, but you can see that the floor now is covered in white. And that's basically what you're going to notice with this preview here. Anywhere that turns white is what is going to form part of your selection. The black areas aren't being selected. But the great thing is, now that I've got the floor selected, I can then come to the fuzziness slider. And I tend to think of that as range. So the more you increase it to the right, it starts to bring in more ranges of colors that it's going to add to that selection. And you'll notice, I know it's small, but as I bring it to the right, you'll start to notice that more of the picture goes white, which means more is being selected. But the actual trees now have started to get a little bit of the selection on it. It's not pure white, it's kind of like a grayish color. And that means we're gonna get a very light dusting of snow. So that's gonna work really, really well. So I make my selection, making sure that the floor is the main part that's being selected and is white. Then I play around with the fuzziness slider. And in this case, I'm gonna drag it right over to the right-hand side and then click okay. Now when we click okay, Photoshop seems to go crazy and the whole picture is covered with marching animals selections. But now what we do is we just go to the layers panel, we add a new blank layer at the top of the layer stack, so it's now above our picture. I'm going to rename that to snow, and then I'm going to go to the edit menu, choose fill, and from where it says contents, we have the drop down menu, and I'm just going to choose white and then click OK. Then we go to select and deselect, wherever that is, deselect right at the top. So there you go, very quickly, just with just a couple of clicks, we've already created a snow scene, and that is pretty realistic. What I really love about it as well, like I mentioned before, when we use that fuzziness slider, is how we've now even brought in a very light dusting of snow onto the trees. You can see all the detail, all the kind of texture, a little bit of the original tree color showing through, so it's really kind of just like dusted across the trees, just like it would in real life, and I absolutely love that. Now, one thing you can also do is, because some of the selection areas certainly on the floor might be a little bit hard in some areas, what I find works is once I've actually got the actual snow on the ground, I then go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and just add in a very small amount, 1 pixel radius of blur, and click OK. So you're pretty much done then, but if you want even more snow on the ground, what you can do is just duplicate that layer by holding down your Command or Control key and pressing J, and you can see then even more snow. Now, that's this tutorial. You could take it a step further by adding falling snow into it. So here's one that I prepared earlier with falling snow, and the way you can create that is, if you go over to my YouTube channel, when you go to the main page, you can click on the little link here that says weekly show and podcasts, and here's where you'll see a list of all the episodes within this weekly show that we've got. Scrolling all the way down, you'll get to episode 30, which is this one just here, and it's called How to Create Realistic Falling Snow. And again, just like most things in Photoshop, it's an incredibly simple technique, but I think you'll probably agree, very, very effective. Now, before we close, just a few points to remember when you're doing this. Let's go back to the original picture and turn off the actual snow on the ground. Now, when you look at this, you'll notice that you can just see the sky coming through the trees. And that's one of the important things is, what does the sky look like? You can't take a regular picture with loads of clouds and sun and all that kind of stuff and expect this to look real. You need to have a sky that has got no detail in it. The sky here is pure white, and that's pretty much what it's like when it's snowing outside. So look for those kind of pictures. Also, you'll notice the lighting in the picture here is very flat. Pretty featureless kind of lighting here. There's no shadows. And that's exactly the kind of lighting you would need and you would see when it's actually snowing in real life. The other thing to think about, or sorry, to remember when you do this, is when we first come in and we use the select and color range, don't expect that the first time you try it, when you click down, you're going to get the perfect result. This took me quite a few attempts to know exactly where on the area to click within this picture to work. If you click in the wrong area, the result is pretty naff, to be honest with you. It doesn't look good. But if you get it right, where the snow's on the ground and everything else is dark, and then just use that fuzziness slider to just add a little bit of a dusting in other areas, you're going to absolutely nail it, and it's going to look really realistic, just as I hope you agree with the final result here. So that's it. That's all I've got for you this week. Told you it was a quick one. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and please just let other people know about it. I really appreciate the support there just by spreading the word, and just let other people come to the channel and just check out all the tutorials that I'm recording every single week and pushing out there. But hey, that's all for this week. I'll see you next time. Oh, one more thing I forgot to mention. Make sure you check out the description part of this video, because in there I've included a link where you can download the file that I used in this tutorial so that you can get practicing straight away. So definitely give that a download, have a play with it, and like I said, I'll see you next time.